Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who willed that the grace of baptism should flourish in these your servants, so that they might strive to follow more closely in the footsteps of your Son, grant, we pray, that constantly seeking evangelical perfection, they may add to the holiness of your church and increase her apostolic zeal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. During the time, young Samuel was a minister to the Lord under Eli. A revelation of the Lord was uncommon and vision infrequent. One day, Eli was asleep in his usual place. His eyes had lately grown so weak that he could not see. The lamp of God was not yet extinguished, and Samuel was sleeping in the temple of the Lord where the ark of God was. The Lord called to Samuel, who answered, "Here I am." He ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." "I did not call you," Eli said. "Go back to sleep." So he went back to sleep. Again, the Lord called Samuel, who rose and went to Eli. "Here I am," he said. "You called me." But Eli answered, "I did not call you, my son. Go back to sleep." At that time, Samuel was not familiar with the Lord, because the Lord had not revealed anything to him as yet. The Lord called Samuel again for the third time. Getting up and going to Eli, he said, "Here I am, you called me." Then Eli understood that the Lord was calling the youth. So Eli said to Samuel, "Go to sleep, and if you are called, reply, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" When Samuel went to sleep in his place, the Lord came and revealed his presence, calling out as before, "Samuel, Samuel." Samuel answered, "Speak, for your servant is listening." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, put on as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, bearing with one another and forgiving one another. If one has grievance against another, as the Lord has forgiven you, so must you also do. And over all these, put on love, that is the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your hearts, the peace into which you are also called in one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, as in all wisdom you teach and admonish one another, singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs with gratitude in your heart to God. And whatever you do, in word and in deed, do everything in the name of Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord, he who lives in me and I in him will bear much fruit.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. He takes away every branch in me that does not bear fruit, and everyone that does, he prunes, so that it bears more fruit. You are already pruned because of the word that I spoke to you. Remain in me as I remain in you. Just as a branch cannot bear fruit on its own unless it remains on the vine, so neither can you unless you remain in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Anyone who remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit, because without me you can do nothing. Anyone who does not remain in me will be thrown out like a branch and wither. People will gather them and throw them into a fire, and they will be burned. If you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask for whatever you want and it will be done for you. By this is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples. As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and your joy may be complete. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Brother Gerald Reno Ramos of the Eucharist and the Cross.
Present.
Brother Stephen Nguyen Biatuan of God.
Present.
My dear brothers, what do you ask of God and of His Holy Church?
I ask for perseverance in God's service and in your family of discalced friars of the Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel all the days of my life.
Thanks be to God.
In today's Gospel, Jesus calls himself the vine, while he refers to the Father as the vine grower, his disciples as the branches, and listening to his word as the fruit. Jesus says the branches that don't bear fruit will eventually be cut off from the vine. This means that people who ignore his words and who go against his commands will eventually be separated from him. While those branches that bear fruit, meaning people who listen to the word of God and follow it, will have to be pruned in order for them to bear more fruit. Now, isn't that ironic? Well, I guess what is true for plants must also be true for people, especially in our spiritual life. You see, to prune means to remove any dead or unwanted branches in a plant. It means cutting off anything that is considered harmful or useless. In short, any obstacle
to growth. Applying this to ourselves, pruning means removing anything in our lives that may be harmful to us in the long run. Anything that prevents us from becoming true followers of Christ. In short, pruning means getting rid of our attachments in life. Now, what exactly is an attachment? Ano ba yung tinatawag nating attachment? Ano ang examples ng mga attachments? For instance, if we as religious are so insecure about money that we even have our own savings for a rainy day, we say, or supposedly for our family, that is an attachment. Or if we stubbornly cling to power, even if we are already stepping on other people's toes, that is an attachment. Or if we strongly believe that our opinion is worth fighting for, never mind if we offend or hurt others in the process, that is an attachment. In short, it could be anything, an object, a person, an activity or idea that gives us so much pleasure or satisfaction that we could not let it go, but which may already be harmful to us and to others. Now, whether it's great or small, whether deep or shallow, it's still an attachment. So you cannot say it's just food or it's just a gadget. You cannot say, oh, but it's only a little attachment, Father, not to worry. St. John of the Cross gives us the image of a bird with a thin thread tied to its leg that keeps it from flying. St. John of the Cross says that even though the thread is easier to break than a thick cord, it nevertheless prevents the bird from flying. The tragedy implied, of course, is something so slight, something so tiny and so trivial can actually have such a great impact on our spiritual life. And here, I remember what a Jesuit priest once said, that many of our corrupt public figures who pocket millions and millions of pesos in taxpayers' money actually started out as little children, stealing pencils. Yes, pencils inside the classroom. And therefore, the real danger is when we begin to rationalize or justify our inordinate tendencies. The real danger is when we begin to underestimate the harm or damage that they can do. For indeed, a thread may be thin, but if we cannot break it, then it is stronger than us. And do you know why it's so difficult to let go of our attachments? Bakit napakahirap? Because they give us so much pleasure and satisfaction and contentment. Ang sarap eh. Masarap. But only for a while. Because soon enough, we become restless again. And a new craving begins. But you see, restlessness is not the problem. It is only a manifestation of our desire for God. As Saint Augustine himself said, our hearts are restless until they rest in God. The real problem is when we try to fill up our restlessness with things that we think will satisfy our longing. And so we cling to our attachments, even if sometimes it is already immoral or sinful. Why? Because we are already blinded. We are already blinded, and so we no longer see what is right or wrong. We no longer see what is good or bad for us. And here, St. John of the Cross gives us another powerful image, that of a moth. Yung gamo-gamo, St. John of the Cross says, a moth is not helped by its eyes because blinded by its desire for the beauty of light, it will fly directly into the flame. And so, no matter how many times we get burned by fire, meaning our attachment, we still go back to it. Over and over and over again. It's like we're crazy. We're simply powerless to say no to our fatal attraction. And the irony of it is that while they are our possessions, we are the ones possessed by them. My dear brothers and sisters, we should realize that the more we cling to our attachments, the more that God cannot enter our life. And that is why we need to empty ourselves. Otherwise, there will be no space in us for God. And this is precisely what St. John of the Cross says in the dark night of the soul. He says, we need to be pruned. We need to be pruned by getting rid of the weeds, which if they go unchecked, will choke and destroy our spiritual growth. In short, we need to let go of our many attachments in life. Painful? Of course. Difficult? Yes. But not impossible. And that is why we need to pray. We need to pray for God's grace. We need to pray for God's strength. Brother Stephen and Brother Reno, I hope you chose today's beautiful gospel, not only because you find it meaningful or significant, but more so because you believe and you are convinced that it can be a guide and inspiration in your religious life. And I hope that as you begin your lifetime commitment and as you look forward to your ordained ministry, you will already learn how to let go of your attachments in life and how to always remain faithful to your prayer life. And this, I guess, is what pruning really means. And as today's gospel says, is the only way that you can bear fruit and become the persons that God intended you to be. Amen.
Dear brothers, in baptism you have already died to sin and been consecrated to God's service. Are you now resolved to unite yourself more closely to God by the bond of perpetual profession?
I am.
Are you resolved, with the help of God, to undertake that life of perfect chastity poverty and obedience, chosen for themselves by Christ our Lord and His Virgin Mother, and to persevere in it forever?
I am.
Are you resolved to strive steadfastly for perfection in the love of God and of your neighbor by living the gospel with all your heart and keeping the rule of the friars of the Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel?
I am.
Are you resolved with the grace of the Holy Spirit and the help of the Virgin Mary, patroness of the order, through constant prayer and apostolic service, to spend your whole life in the generous service of God's people?
I am.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment before the day of Christ Jesus. Dear friends in Christ, let us pray to God the Almighty Father that through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, for these servants of His, whom He has called to follow Christ in the Theresian family, in His love may He bless them with His grace and strengthen them in His holy purpose.
Let us all kneel.
Saint
Anne.
Carmelite saints and blessed,
pray for
your arms.
All holy men and women, saints of God,
pray for us.
Lord, be merciful.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
from all evil.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
from every sin.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
from everlasting. And resurrection.
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
By the outpouring of the Holy Spirit.
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
Be merciful to us, sinners.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
The self-offering of your servants and their apostolic word, make the life of your church ever more fruitful.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Give in ever greater abundance the gifts of the Holy Spirit to your servant Pope Francis and to all his brother bishops.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
By the life and labor of all religious, promote the welfare of all mankind.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Lead all men and women the fullness of Christian life.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Grant that all religious communities may live and grow in the love of Christ, the Spirit of their founders.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Preserve and increase the spirit of prayer and apostolic love for the church in this community and in the whole family of Carmel.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Give to all who profess the gospel counsels a fuller share in the work of redemption.
Lord, we ask
Lord, a hundredfold the parents of your servants for the sacrifice they have made.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Make these servants of yours more and more like Christ, the firstborn of many brothers.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
These servants of yours the grace of perseverance.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bless these brothers of ours, your servants. Make them holy and consecrate them to your service.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Jesus, Son of the living God,
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Christ, graciously.
Lord, grant the prayers of your people. Prepare the hearts of your servants for consecration to your service. By the grace of the Holy Spirit, purify them from all sin and set them on fire with your love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please rise.
I, Brother Gerald Reno V. Ramos of the Eucharist and the Cross, desiring to live faithfully with the Virgin Mary, a life of allegiance to Jesus Christ, with my brothers as witnesses and in your presence, Brother Danilo D. Lim of the Immaculate Heart of Mary, OCD, vow to Almighty God for life, chastity, poverty, and obedience, according to the rules and constitutions of the Order of Discalced Brothers of the Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel. With my whole heart, I give myself to this family founded by Saint Teresa, that by the grace of the Holy Spirit and the help of the Mother of God, by constant prayer and apostolic activity in the service of our Mother, the Church, I may attain to perfect charity and give eternal glory to the Most Holy Trinity.
I, Brother Stephen Nguyen Viet Tuong of God, desiring to live faithfully with the Virgin Mary, a life of allegiance to Jesus Christ, with my brothers as witnesses, and in your presence, Brother Danilo Lim of the Immaculate Heart of Mary, OCD, vow to Almighty God for life, chastity, poverty, and obedience, according to the rule and constitutions of the Order of Discalced Brothers of the Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel. With my whole heart, I give myself to this family founded by Saint Teresa, that by the grace of the Holy Spirit and the help of Mother of God, by constant prayer and apostolic activity in the service of our Mother, the Church, I may attain to perfect charity and give eternal glory to the Most Holy Trinity.
Thank you.
please stand?
Our prayer of consecration. Father in heaven, source of all holiness, creator of the human race, your love for us was so great that you gave us a share in your own divine life. Neither the sin of Adam, nor even the sins of the whole world could alter your loving purpose. In the dawn of history, you gave us Abel as an example of holiness. Later, from your beloved Hebrew people, you raised up men and women graced with every virtue. Foremost among them all stands Mary, the ever-virgin daughter of Zion. From her pure womb was born Jesus Christ, your eternal Word, the Savior of the world. You sent him, Father, as our pattern of holiness. He became poor to make us rich, a slave to set us free. With love no words can tell, he redeemed the world by his Paschal mystery and won from you the gifts of the Spirit to sanctify his church. We confirm that the voice of the Spirit has drawn countless numbers of your children to follow in the footsteps of your Son. They leave all things to be one with you in the bonds of love and give themselves wholly to your service and the service of all your people. Look with favor then on our brothers who have heard your call. Send them the Spirit of holiness. Help them to fulfill in faith what you have enabled them to promise in joy. Keep always before their eyes Christ, the divine teacher. Give them perfect chastity, ungrudging poverty, and wholehearted obedience. May they glorify you by their humility, serve you with docility, and be one with you in fervent love. May they build up the church by the holiness of their lives, advance the salvation of the world, and stand as a sign of the blessings that are to come. Lord, protect and guide these servants of yours. At the judgment seat of your Son, be yourself their great reward. Give them the joy of vows fulfilled. Made perfect in your love, may they rejoice in the communion of your saints and praise you forever in their company. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Receive this image of your crucified and risen Lord. May God, who has revealed his glory to us in Christ, bring your life into conformity with the image of his Son, so that you may reach the vision of his glory. Receive the rule and constitutions of the order. By following the example of the Blessed Virgin Mary, show in your whole life your desire to be a true discalced Carmelite, like our holy parents, Saint Teresa of Jesus and Saint John of the Cross. Receive this image of your crucified and risen Lord. May God, who has revealed his glory to us in Christ, bring your life into conformity with the image of his Son, so that you may reach the vision of his glory. Receive the rule and constitutions of the order by following the example of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Show in your whole life your desire to be a true discalced Carmelite, like our holy parents, Saint Teresa of Jesus and Saint John of the Cross. We confirm that you are now one with us as members of this religious community of the discalced brothers of the Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel, sharing all things in common with us now and in the future. Be faithful to the ministry the Church has entrusted to you to be carried out in her name.
Amen.
Jesus.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Receive the gifts and intentions of your servants, O Lord, and confirm in your love those who profess the evangelical counsels. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. He is the unblemished flower who sprang from the root of the Virgin and declared the pure of heart blessed, teaching by His way of life the surpassing worth of chastity. He chose always to hold fast to what is pleasing to you, and becoming obedient for our sake even until death, He willingly offered Himself to you as a perfect and a fragrant sacrifice. He consecrated to a fuller service of your majesty those who for love of you leave all earthly things and promised they would find treasure in heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take these, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offerings to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Saint Teresa of Avila and Saint John of the Cross, Blessed Dennis and Redemptus, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Onesto, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Strengthen in their holy resolve, O Lord, these your servants, who today have bound themselves to you perpetually in the sacred bands of religious profession, and grant that they may show forth in your church the new and eternal life purchased by Christ's redemption. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to you, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, thank you. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Of spiritual communion, my Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
I have loved you with a
Let us pray. Having received with reverence the divine mysteries, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, to inflame with the fire of the Holy Spirit these your servants, bound to you now by an act of sacred offering, and to admit them forever to the company of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated for a message of thanksgiving.
My dear fathers, brothers, relatives and friends in Christ, with joyful heart, Brother Reno and I would like to take this opportunity to express our gratitude to all of you for your prayers, love and care. It is a great blessing for both of us when we have our solemn profession in the order of Discalced Carmelites, OCD. First of all, we would like to thank Father Dan, our provincial superior, on the behalf of the order, welcome us to the Discalced Carmelite family and presiding the Mass to pray for us today. We would like to say thank you to all of our formators who have accompanied us for many years through different stages of formations, especially to Father Jonal, our postulant director, Father Ramil, our novice master, Father Vito, Father Haluwen, Father Richard, and Father Joni, our student directors, and Father Dan Foster, our second novitiate master. Maraming salamat po for being good examples for mentors to us, and for your constant prayer for our perseverance and for your patience in journey with us for the past 9 years of formation with hope. Brother Reno and I will try our best to live faithfully our Carmelite vocation and cultivate more day after day. We believe that formation is a lifetime formation, not just a matter of years. So keep on praying for us and journey with us. And I also never forget to mention here Father Peter Votakhan, my uncle who introduced me to Carmel when I was 15 years old, and Father Andre, whom I stayed with for some years as an aspirant in Saigon, patiently planted the seed of Carmelite vocations in Vietnam. Thank you very much for your love, care, and labor for the mission in Vietnam. God knows and rewards you for what you have sacrificed for us. Throughout the years of formation programs, we of course embrace deeply in our heart the extended Carmelite families who allow us to immerse ourselves in their own families for an exposure. The family of Nanay Cynthia, Nanay Penang, and Nanay Aurin, former barangay captain in Alimujan town, and the family of Tita Mei Chan, Tita Judith, Tita Tesdi, Tita Florin, and many other families which we cannot mention all here. Thank you very much for being part of formation team to teach us by your way of life. And we would like to give thanks to Carmelite sisters of different communities who have prayed day and night for us, especially for our perseverance in our vocation. We also would like to thank
the different OCDS communities over the Philippines and Vietnam for joining us in the live stream celebration. And your prayer is the most wonderful gift God has given us. The Carmelite Scholastics Foundation members who are wholeheartedly supporting us to study at the best schools of philosophy and theology are in our heart and prayer too. Thank you very much for your helping. We humbly thanks to our Carmelite brothers who are very much supportive to us despite they are super busy at this time with academic requirements, spending time to serve as readers, singers, flowers, decoration, many other hidden works also. Our gratitude to all who serve in this mass, the golden voice of our commentator, Tita Corey, the angelic voice of the Te Deum choir, the prayerful violinist player, David Ipapo, PowerPoint operator, Arvin, parish sacristan leading by Joey, liturgical live streaming service operator, Michael, Kuya Jude Liao as our MC, and especially Reverend Justin, and also other workers and staffs of the parish. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, our parish priest of the Basilica of the National Shrine of Our Lady of Mount Carmel, Father Willow, for supporting us with all means in preparing for this solemn and meaningful celebration of our religious life. Just allow us to say some words to our parents. Sa tatay, nanay, salamat po for bring us to life, educated us, teach us faith, and now you are offering your sons to God and the church. Salamat po. And keep on praying for us. And just allow me to say a few words in Vietnamese to my family, relatives and friends in Vietnam, those are attending online celebration. Con xin cảm ơn ba mẹ, các em và mọi người trong gia đình đã không ngừng khích lệ, nâng đỡ và cầu nguyện cho con trên con đường tận hiến cho nước trời và phục vụ tha nhân. Con biết rằng dâng một người con cho Thiên Chúa sẽ là một hy sinh rất lớn cho mọi người, vì mọi người sẽ phải cầu nguyện cho con rất nhiều để con có thể sống trung thành với ơn gọi của mình. Con cũng xin cảm ơn các anh em trong nhà dòng, các mẹ, các chị dòng kín, cha sở, cha phó và các cha đã từng giúp xứ ở sông Mỹ, cùng với mọi người trong giáo xứ đã yêu thương, dìu dắt, dạy dỗ, nâng đỡ và cầu nguyện liên lỉ cho con khi con chỉ là cậu bé 15 tuổi. Khát khao đi tu dòng các Minh Teresa, hôm nay hạt giống ơn gọi ấy đã dần nảy mầm và sinh hoa kết trái. Mỗi ngày con cầu nguyện và xin Thiên Chúa tuôn đổ muôn ơn phúc xuống trên mọi người như là món quà Chúa thương ban cho tất cả những hy sinh của mọi người. Xin tiếp tục đồng hành với con qua lời kinh sớm hôm. Xin cùng hiệp ý với con dâng lên lời ca tạ ơn Đức Mẹ và Chúa Giêsu qua lời kinh bài hát Salve Regina. Please join us in singing the song Salve Regina to tribute to Mary, Mother of God, and our Mother.
Please rise.
Queen, you're in heaven.
Spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
May God, the inspirer of every good resolve, foster your purposes and strengthen your hearts that what you have promised you may keep with persevering faith.
Amen.
May He grant you to hasten in the joy of Christ along the narrow way you have chosen, rejoicing to bear the burdens of your brothers and sisters.
Amen.
May the charity of God make of you a family brought together in the Lord's name to show forth the image of the love of Christ.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.